Hello there, guys and gals. The Welsh Hunter here, back with yet another 100% achievement and trophy guide. And this time we are getting it all in Macrotis, A Mother's Journey. This cutesy, fun, yet beautiful looking puzzle platformer is developed by Proud Dinosaurs, published by EastAsiaSoft, and is available to you for just £9.99. So we play as Mother Macrotis. Ah, no, sorry, not Macrotis. Ah, luckily they didn't give her a surname like Itchy. Eh? Eh? Get it? Okay. But seriously, we do play as the mother, sort of rat, Macrotis, who somehow after a storm gets trapped underground while her kids and husband stay up top. I mean, is the husband really lacking that bad that she can't just take her time getting out? Well, anyway, that is our job. So we go through this entire game with beautiful backgrounds, solving puzzles and platforming our way back up. Now, as for achievements and trophies, nothing is actually missable, but because some of these puzzles can get slightly more challenging as the game progresses, that is why I've done a guide. Now, this video is only about an hour and a half long as well, but depending on your skill, it may take a little bit longer, so be wary of that. Otherwise, 2 to 3 hours, maybe 4 potentially, is what you're looking at. So, with that being said then, now we can begin. Now, I won't actually be doing any commentary in this video. Some of you may be disappointed to hear, while others may be hella relieved. But everything you need will come up on screen anyway, so new techniques, new powers, etc. So it's very easy to use, remember, and learn, so you really should have no issues. Also, I just want to say, the mother in this game actually has the cutest, most loving, motherly voice I've ever heard. Honestly, you just want to pinch her cheeks and put her in your pocket. But anyway, and again, then there's the wizard guy for some reason. But you'll know all of that when you sort of come to it. Anyways, I will be back at the end. Also, do not worry about collectibles either. We do not need to grab them. All we need to do is just go through the game and you will unlock all the achievements and trophies. So enjoy, my beautiful people. Enjoy this.
To get out of here and get back to my kids. This place looks familiar. I'm glad I wasn't dragged too far away. Please be safe, please be safe. That place doesn't look very sturdy. I don't know how to swim. I hope I won't fall. Jump across. I can gnaw those roots to free the rock, but I'm sure they taste disgusting. I need to go up. Why is this place always going down? Mommy is on her way, kids. Hold on. Finally, I'm going up. But that spider is bigger than me. There may be a way down there. I don't understand why people are afraid of spiders, really. That that was a long fall. Oh, he must be preparing for the winter, I guess. Nobody was there. Hey, wait for me. Wait, stop. Why aren't you waiting for me? Thank you. I made it. Why aren't you waiting for me? Hey, I'm talking to you. Yoo-hoo! Can't you hear me, maybe? Oh, I wish you would answer me. Oh, come on. I wish you could hear me. How am I going to catch you again?
Thank you so much. Next time I will definitely visit you with my children. What is this lock doing here? Thank you. can't dig through from this side. My hands! This rock alone will not be enough for me to reach there. Giant mushrooms? I can't believe it. I remember having picnics under such mushrooms. I must keep this place in mind. My oldest must definitely see these.
Thank you. While she was digging the path of earth in front of her, she had only a single thing in her mind. Her children. She did not care about the fall of the huge crystal, even though inwardly she knew how dangerous it was. She looked at the path upwards with hope and started climbing while raindrops fell on her face. Unfortunately, the crystal exploded. Meanwhile, I was trying... Let us take care of this darkness first. This may hurt a little, though.
But why?
You are not used to magic. Do not worry. I will only do this when it is absolutely necessary.
Okay, I'm ready. Wow! But how are we going to stop the rain? Will it hurt as much?
Most probably. But we need to go much deeper for that. Let us save your children first.
I feel weird. Is it because of the magic?
Could be. Be careful. There's a waterfall up ahead.
Oh no, I died?
Calm down, little one. This is the magical form which I used to converse with you before. How you managed to do it, though, is a mystery to me.
What am I going to do? How will I get back to my body?
If you move away from your body sufficiently, this form will vanish, and you will get back to your physical form.
Okay. How am I going to get past here? I can break these if I jump on top of them.
Are you aware of the concept of meditation?
Yeah, sure. Why?
A demonstration is in order then. Close your eyes. Imagine yourself leaving your body behind and moving away from it.
I did it! But how is this going to help?
The magical form is weightless. Therefore, you cannot break those if you jump on top of them. In addition, you possess the abilities of your physical form in the magical form too. But beware, hazards that hurt your physical form will dispel the magical form.
Hey, I can go further away from my body now.
You will be able to go further as you get used to the magic. However, there will always be a limit.
Okay. I can't jump that high.
Correct. What you can, however, is passing through thin formations while in the magical form.
How?
Approach the wall and put your hands on it. Then, push forward.
Hey, I did it! But I feel like my limit got shorter.
Naturally. But do not worry. It is not permanent. Your boundary will be reset every time you enter the form.
Thank you.
Is the weirdness you experience still persisting?
No, I guess I got used to it.
It is more likely that the magic got used to you. I feel...
You've been quiet for a while.
I have a question I would like to ask, but I do not know how appropriate it is.
Just ask directly.
I thought you bilbies became extinct.
Now that you think about it, there are fewer of us.
I encountered your species only in books. I reached this age, and yet you are the first bilby I have ever seen with my own eyes.
Then you're going to be very happy when you see my children.
But we can clear the way if we could drop those rocks up there. However, it would be better to check ahead first. Rain!
What? I can see the way out, but I can't reach there. Look at the flood here. I can't imagine how it is up there. Oh, my kids.
Easy there, little one. By pondering over these things, you're only hurting yourself. I am certain that nothing has happened to them. They are your children, after all. You have overcome many difficulties even before meeting me. I am sure we can reach them. Now get up. We have a long way ahead.
You're right. I can't lose hope now.
Thank you.
We need to get that stone down here.
Why? What is wrong with rivers?
I don't know how to swim.
I see. To drop the stones in the water before we get there.
No, stop! You're going to kill us!
Sorry, my old friend. You have to find food somewhere else.
We got through. I can't believe we did it.
You underestimate yourself. You still do not realize the greatness of your deeds thus far.
Thank you. You mentioned that we had to go deeper to stop the rain. What then?
I sense a great congregation of magical power down there. We have to reach it.
I was gonna say that if it was simple, we could deal with it quickly, so my kids would be safe.
It is not, unfortunately. First, we need to find the source and siphon the necessary power. Then we need to find somewhere we can see the sky and cast a similar spell to the one I was casting.
It sounds difficult.
Do not worry yourself now. We have urgent matters to attend to.
Again. silent again?
I was pondering something.
Did you lose hope about finding a way up too? Have we gone deep enough?
Not really, but I sense that we are getting close.
Then let's stop the rain first. There's no way up from here. Maybe we can find a way from there.
Are you certain?
Yes. The rain is getting faster. We are nowhere close to the surface, and there is no way going up. We have to stop the rain. Not only my kids, but many living things depend on us.
I am sorry, little one. It saddens me to burden you with such a great responsibility.
Don't blame yourself.
You as well. And so we continued our journey downwards. Even though we decided to proceed and stop the rain, we could not help our wandering eyes to search for paths to the surface. However, our efforts were in vain. On our way into the depths, we encountered some unusual objects that did not fit the natural environment surrounding us. Mother Bilby queried as to whether the objects that we came upon were too small for humans. While we were passing through an opening that we deemed sturdy enough, I started to disclose to her what I knew about this ancient race. These objects must belong to a race we describe as the Small Folk. We did not encounter them for a long time, though. In fact, I'm as surprised as you are. I have read that their craftsmanship defied the passing of ages, but I did not expect this level of preservation.
This place looks abandoned. I wonder if something happened.
Even though this looks very confusing, the markings on the mechanism match the ones that are on the doors they affect. Interesting.
us down.
Of course. We use these types of mechanisms on multiple storage structures for ease of transportation. Actually, the general purpose of these kinds of mechanisms is easy transportation from one place to the other. By another mechanism. Beware!
Whew. Luckily I'm small. They really don't want anyone passing through here.
We must be more careful. Who knows what other traps await us?
I wish I could have enjoyed that ride. You don't have a weighted magical form, right?
Huh. Regretfully, no.
This is the first time I hear you laughing.
Even in the darkest of times, you should cling to your smile like a lifeline, for it is your greatest weapon against despair.
You're right. I tell my children that all the time. Let's listen to my own advice. Do you have kids?
I even have grandchildren. You know how sweet but exhausting it is to take care of your child. My son never listened to me. He went ahead and joined the army just to spite his wizarding father. Furthermore, he even married at a young age against my warnings. Naturally, I ceased complaining after having grandchildren. Love of a grandchild is very different. You enjoy all the love being a parent brings, but experience none of the difficulties. The realization of your own child being an actual adult now is also a delight. My son has three children, like you do. My oldest grandchild is serving in the army like my son. Middle one is aspiring to be a diplomat, just like my daughter-in-law. And the youngest is following in my footsteps, against all of my son's objections.
Oh, you must really love them. It's the first time you talk about something this long.
We'll be right back.
This kitchen is huge. My son is a great cook, you know. I even envy him sometimes. Wow, to think I called the kitchen huge.
I wish we could see this place in its prime.
What kind of river is this? Why is it that hot?
It is a river of molten earth, which is called lava, and it is very dangerous.
Oh, just like normal rivers then. Oh no!
Calm down. Visualize creating a wall in front of you. I will assist you, but this will hurt a bit.
I did it! Why didn't you give me this power to me before if we could create walls? Oh, how easy and quick it would be to come this far if I had this power from the beginning.
You are correct. However, my power decreases every time I grant you with more power. And I already told you that I would not give you more if it was not a necessity, because we do not know what kinds of obstacles we will face in the future. You did not need this power to go on until now. More importantly, if my magical power depletes completely, I may vanish, and you cannot do the spell alone.
I wish you explained this before. I wouldn't have gotten angry.
I did not want to scare you by telling these earlier. Tears.
Getting that wall power.
There is a door down below, but it is underwater. There is a door down below, but it is underwater. Probably there was an elevator here. Fortunately, there is still a way down.
Elevator?
What?
We must be quick. You should see our capital. It really is a glorious place, filled with wonder and awe. Highest towers of the land, daring the clouds in the sky, surrounded by smooth, pure white walls. And the castle, with its shining windows ornamented with colorful stained glass.
And I took that from you.
No, no, you did not. Even though certain events led to the specific outcome, the spell you have interrupted would be my last regardless. You only changed the course, not the end, little one. My destiny was sealed when I started to cast that spell. Decades ago, my master saw a vision about me. He told me that I would cast this spell at the expense of my own life.
I don't know what to feel now. I interrupted your first attempt at the spell. What will happen to us when we finish it together?
This spell needs a vast amount of magical power. However, considering we utilize the magic underneath us, nothing will happen to you. To me, on the other hand, I cannot predict. I wish we could save your children first.
I'm sure nothing's gonna happen to you. We will go on that picnic with your family and mine. Then you'll show me your capital.
I hope you are right. That gas looks dangerous.
It stinks, too.
We are getting near. I am starting to feel the exact direction of the source. And I suspect there is more than one.
Will it be a problem for us?
No, it will not. The only problem we may encounter is the spell's requirement of having a visual connection to the sky.
Do you have any plans for it?
One step at a time, little one. This combination of markings resembles a symbol from an ancient story.
What kind of story?
I remember it vaguely, but as far as I recall, it also had three siblings in it.
This place smells disgusting. Blech.
This must be the place where they produce the gas. is hate and cruel. We are getting close. I sense that there are three magical sources beneath us. We are nearing our goal. Craftsmanship indeed. One of the sources is right behind that door. Apparently, the items that contain the magical power we seek hold more value to the small folk than the treasures around us. We could not see a mechanism that opened the door in front of us. While I was pondering on what to do next, she confidently walked towards the door. How could I have known a simple push would be sufficient to open the door? I did not expect that open a door would be this simple.
Actually, me neither. Doesn't this horizontal elevator look kinda useless?
To us? Maybe. However, small folk must have a purpose in mind when building this. Thank you. the source we were looking for.
So what am I going to do now?
Reach towards it and imagine yourself siphoning the magic inside. I will endeavor to aid you with my own magic.
We did it. Is it just me, or does each room we pass get more difficult?
We dealt with much worse than this. Do not worry. We will quickly deal with this too. one left.
Where we can see the sky after we gather all the crystals, right?
Yes, little one. But do not worry. There is enough fresh air for such a closed space, suggesting an airflow from somewhere.
This elevator must be our way out of here.
Yes. But first, we need to siphon the magic out of the last crystal, too. Let us use that elevator and check if there is an opening to outside.
This place is awesome.
This must be the tomb of an old king of theirs. They have built a glorious mausoleum.
I can't see a way out of here, but I think fresh air comes behind that wall.
I think this wall may object to our attempts of moving it.
So, don't you have a spell that we can use?
We could attempt to destroy the wall, but that would consume a sizable portion of the magical power we siphoned. In addition, I do not know how it would affect you. If we decide to do that, the spell to stop the rain may require your life force as well.
As if we have any other options. Look, I don't care what happens to me when my children face death up there.
Very well. Focus the magical power inside of you, and imagine hitting the wall with it. Hold on. It's almost over.
So there we have it then, guys and gals. That is the game done now. Thank you, Mallory, by the way, for the nicest voice I've ever heard in gaming. I don't even care. It was so cute. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, guys and gals. I really do hope that this guide has helped. I know it's a rarity where I did no commentary whatsoever. In this case, I thought it might have helped. Again, if you would have preferred commentary, or if not, just let me know in the comments section below, and then obviously I'll go off that. But again, thank you very, very much for watching, guys and gals. Hope that it did help. You can check me out on all my social medias, of course, Twitter and Instagram. Also on Patreon now as well. So if you want to be in with a chance to win some pretty cool things, check out the links in the description box. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe on this channel. And, well, that is that. Thank you very much also to TimG84 for continuing to support the channel on Patreon. Big shout out to him. Thank you again for watching, guys and gals. See you in the next one, then. Big love.
Thank you.